In this video we're going to look at hatchings, symbols on construction drawings that represent materials used to build whatever it is you're building. Let's have a look.
Okay, this video I'm going to show how to read plans. On plans, drawings, construction drawings, you see something called hatchings or symbols, and they represent the materials used to build whatever it is you're building. Like, for example, brickwork. Two lines at a 45 degree angle. If you see that on a drawing, that's brickwork. Rockwork. Is a cross. If you see that, that's blockwork. Insulation. It's a continual kind of snake or S shape that goes down like that. You see that's insulation. So you have brickwork there, blockwork, and insulation there. You also, this is a strict foundation, concrete, a few triangles in the corners there, some circles, and then some dots. That's concrete. Okay, so if I put them together, I was going to draw a cavity wall. I'll have the foundation there. This is a section drawing. It's like cutting through the wall and looking in the end to see the materials. So you have the foundation there. Brick wall, insulation, block work, slightly bigger, brick work, the two lines coming down at an angle, insulation, come down. The block work, as the X, and there you'll have a cavity filled. You've got the external ground there, the internal flooring 150mm higher, three lines that way, three lines that way, three lines that way, and so on. That is soil. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. There you have soil. Now this is a strip foundation. Let's put the concrete in there. A few triangles, few circles and dots. The dots are the sand and the small circles and triangles are the ballast. Smaller dots, cement. So you've got brickwork, you know that's brickwork. You see, you don't have to write all the words in, the architect doesn't need to do that. We know that's brickwork. We know that's insulation. We know that's blockwork. The cavity fill, that could be cavity fill, that could be different things, that might be concrete. It's normally a slush, kind of a light concrete. You know that's soil, you've got three lines that way, continuous. What about on the inside? So that's your trench that's been dug out. The trench goes a long way. So underneath the flooring you'll have hardcore. Hardcore. If you see that, that's hardcore. So we'll put the hardcore in here. Press down. Above the hardcore you might have sharp sand, which is lots of small dots. Above the sharp sand you'll have a membrane, which is a big large sheet of plastic, which is two lines like so. With a white kind of dash going across it. Above the membrane, you might have some more insulation. They're very up on their insulation nowadays. On top of the insulation, which is a bit funny there, on top of the insulation, you'll have screeding, which is similar to sharp sand, and you can do lots of little dots. So if you saw that, initially it looked like lots of crosses and lines and so on, but if you know what they represent, you'll know that that foundation is concrete. You'll know that's the outside of the building because that's topsoil. You'll know that the trench on the inside has been filled up with hardcore. On top of hardcore you've got sharp sand, then you've got your membrane. On top of that you've got insulation, on top of that you've got screeding. So you would recognise all these. Also, I'll just go over some others, quick ones that you'll see on plans. You've got, I'm not trying to remember these, a window. If you're looking at the front elevation, so you're looking at the front of the house, or you'll get something called a window and door specification. There you'll have a window, but you want to know what side it opens. So if that opens from the right, you'll have two lines going up at an angle like that, which means it opens from the right, that's where the hinges are. If you have another window, opens from the left, you'll have two lines coming from there. So that means the hinges are on that side. If, like on a lot of high-rise buildings, it opens from the top, you have the lines going up there. So that's like an arrow pointing to where the hinges are. If also on some high-rise buildings it opens from the bottom, you'll have that down like that. Varying different windows. We've got door openings. What they do, that's your wall. That curved line shows where the door swings, how far it opens. So people planning, they know not to put any furniture or anything in the way there. You've got double doors. Which you can see there. From the top, from plan perspective, you might have the wall there, and you'll have the window protruding out like that. Two planes of glass. And that's your double glazed windows. What else have you got? Yeah, the bath you've got. You've got simply a top there, that's a bath. A square. Sometimes have a dot in the middle, that's the shower. An oval or two ovals like this, sometimes it might have a, that's your toilet. And just write them down there so I remember them all. That's a double sink. Single sink. As you can see, they look similar to what they actually are. Have a look, that's your bath, shower, sink, toilet, double sink, and windows. Windows are open from various parts. And there you've got your doors, that's a window as well. And you've got your doors here. you an idea.
The hatchings used to represent materials in construction drawings. Subscribe and leave a comment. Thanks. See you on the next video.